Wow, what a great heavyweight battle. Dakota McPherson, you know, he could probably be one of the toughest heavyweights we have around. 4-0, 4 TKO wins. But coming up next is a middleweight battle. Coming out first is a very, very impressive young man, Raheem Rambo Forrest. He's coached by Kevin Henry at the Phalanx Fight Team. He's going to have Kevin and Mark Beckwith, one of the Ram wrestling coaches, in his corner. He's got a record of 2-1, considers himself a freestyle fighter. Just 19 years of age, 5'11", weighed in at 181.8 pounds for this middleweight battle, which is 185-pound weight limit. From Memphis, Tennessee, and still representing and fighting out of Memphis, Tennessee, this young man is built to knock people out. What do you think about Rambo?
Yeah, Rambo Forrest, man, he's definitely built to knock people out. The guy's a heavy hitter. I've seen him fight before. Now he's been working with Mark Beckwith on his wrestling. So, I mean, that's just another layer added to his repertoire. Young guy, 19 years old, still kind of getting his footing in the sport. But I think this is a guy that you're going to see get better and better and better all the time. The guy is jacked, man. He is built. So you know, this guy's in great shape, too.
He's fought, you know, he can fight it at welterweight at the 170-pound division. His opponent pulled out. Another person's, Khalil's opponent, pulled out. Two fights in a row, someone's pulled out of Khalil. Khalil said, look, I'll take a fight with anybody. Just get me in that cage. These guys are friends. They probably trained together before, but when the cage door closes, they really don't care. And speaking of Killer Breeze, Khalil Boyd, he's making his way to the cage now. Says he has no coaches, but in his corner is going to be Den Bates, one of our exciting welterweights, and Donovan Castillo. His record is 4-3. He's been extremely active in the past 2 years with 7 fights. Considers his style Wu-Tang. Only 20 years old, representing Rick Severa, which is a group of guys, James Kangaroo Wells, Den the Master Bates. Those guys all get together. They made their own team. He stands 6 feet tall, 184.8 pounds from Memphis. He's actually the Apex middleweight champion. And he's looking to establish himself in the V3 cage.
Yeah, he comes from an interesting team. The Rick Severa team, led by Den Bates. We've seen Den Bates' coach fight many times before. They have a very unorthodox style. And Khalil does too. Very unorthodox. He'll go out there and throw like jumping knees and spinning kicks and spinning back fists and stuff. Very unorthodox. But he has to be very careful doing anything orthodox against Raheem. Because Raheem has some heavy hands. Heavy hands. He's got to keep his hands up. Try not to do anything too fancy. But I love this matchup. I love this matchup. This is definitely two tough guys who are up and coming, who have two completely different styles. This is going to be some fireworks. I think we're going to see one of the best fights we've seen tonight thus far, for sure.
You know, Khalil himself, he's pretty jacked himself. He came in 184.8 pounds, so he's going to have a couple pounds on him. Like we said, Forrest is 5'11", Khalil Boyd 6 feet. It's freestyle versus Wu-Tang. A 2-1 record versus 4-3. Both of them not legal to drink alcohol yet at 19 and 20 years old, and both hailing from Memphis, Tennessee. Boyd's going to be entering the cage now. You'll see that he's got quite a physique on him as well. He is built to strike, to kick, and if he lands it, he's going to hurt you. He's a durable, tough, athletic kid, as you see with that one-handed cartwheel as he gets into the cage. But let's take it inside to Mike Kelly for the official introduction.
V3 Legion, this bout is brought to you by Fireball Cinnamon Whiskey in a separate three-minute rounds in the middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears the blue trunks with the white and black trim. At 5'11", he weighed in at 181.8 pounds. A freestyle fighter representing Phalanx and fighting out of Memphis, Tennessee, Raheem Rambo Forrest. And across the cage, his adversary fighting out of the red corner. He wears the navy blue trunks with the white and blue trim. At 6 feet even, he weighed in at 184.8 pounds. A Wu-Tang fighter representing Rick Severa MMA and fighting out of Memphis, Tennessee, Khalil Killer Breeze Boyd.
So here we go for this middleweight battle, which could potentially be a number one contender fight.
Man, I'm pumped. This is going to be a good fight.
Khalil originally supposed to fight Lorenzo Nathan, one of the top fighters in the area.
You see what I mean? What did I say? He was going to come out with something unorthodox, and sure enough, he did, and he got taken down for his efforts.
He paid for it, getting taken down, and as you see, Raheem had side control for a second, but now he's moving back into half guard. But he's got a pretty dominant position with him pushed up against the cage. You don't want Raheem on top of you throwing punches.
No, and he's got to be careful about letting Khalil get up in this position.
Khalil's trying to work that single leg.
Yep.
But watch out for an armbar here.
Yeah, not a super slick technique on that armbar there. Kind of had it on the wrong side. Oh, and he lets him get back up. Nice little takedown, little dump.
Raheem on top with the light blue shorts. Kill a breeze. Khalil Boyd on the bottom in the dark blue.
Yeah, and they're still kind of feeling each other out here.
Just a minute into the fight.
Yeah, Raheem would be well served to kind of clear his head and get some posture here. Obviously, Khalil wants to keep that head close so he can't get off any heavy strikes from the top position. You see he's hooking his leg also there. This prevents Raheem from being able to get posture.
Sometimes you don't realize how strong your opponent is until he picks you up like a baby and slams you down to the mat. Then you realize, you know, we got to change game plans here. But no real significant damage yet from Raheem. Khalil trying to get up, but gives up his back in the process.
Yeah, not a good position here.
So Raheem is a little high.
Yeah, he's real high. He can get rolled or turned.
If Khalil just popped his hips up, Raheem would have gone right over top of him.
Nice uppercut and left hook.
Wow, nice uppercuts. He's throwing for the fences here. You can hear his coaches saying knees, knees, knees. But Killabreeze, he is a tough, durable guy.
Yeah, he's eating some punches, though, I tell you. And a nice front kick, nice uppercut. And he's just getting swung at. Oh, and he comes back with his own uppercut.
But Killabreeze goes down to a knee as well. They're both back up, exchanging punch after punch.
I told you this is going to be exciting. No matter what, this is going to be exciting.
I was excited when I saw this matchup. I was excited when Killabreeze was going to fight Lorenzo Nathan. I'm always excited to see these Rick Savera guys go at it.
All right, now we have Raheem on top, looking for that ground to pound once again. But Khalil continually tries to get up from this bottom position. He does a good job of moving his hips away. Raheem would be well served to keep him down. Don't let him back up. Don't let him back up.
You're staying on your knees. You're not keeping a lot of pressure on your opponent.
That's right. And that's the key.
Khalil's able to just kind of get back up. There's really nothing preventing him from standing up.
Wow.
We end round one. I think probably a pretty clear round for Raheem.
Yes.
Nice takedowns. Raheem might have gotten rocked a little bit with a punch, but he followed right back up with a punch himself that put Killabreeze on his knee and stunned him. Definitely owned the stand-up, the takedowns. Great round. You see Killabreeze isn't even sitting down, just taking some water. You might have a cut, maybe some swelling. Crystal Morrow's over in the corner trying to watch him. Here we see Killabreeze came out with a, like you predicted, wild flying kick, almost like Verdum did against Travis Brown. Got caught, taken down. They're exchanging blows as hard as they can.
Yeah, and both guys just hung in there. Both guys got tagged on the stand-up part.
Both guys did. Both guys throwing everything. It shows their durability and toughness, and this is an absolutely exciting fight.
Yeah, wait till these guys get better skills. They're still young. Wait till they refine their skills more. These guys are going to be tough, man. They're explosive, strong, athletic.
Just 19 and 20 years old.
Yep.
Raheem kind of had his hand on his hips. Usually a sign of being tired. So
yeah, they
let's
come
see
right
if
out,
that plays.
He comes right out firing. Oh, nice overhand right.
Khalil not keeping his hands up.
No. Khalil now drives Raheem into the fence here right in front of us.
Looking for some knees. Remember, as amateurs, you can't knee the head. Oh, it looks like nice. He threw a nice punch. It might be over here.
Oh, wow. He's trying to finish here.
Raheem kind of looks like he's shaking the cobwebs a little bit. Reached for a single leg.
Yeah, he looks like he's out of it. He looks like he is out of it.
He's got his eyes closed. Clint's really looking at this close. He's going to stop the fight.
Yeah, I think that's
Raheem is done.
That's it. Yeah, good stoppage by Clint Kolesinski. Good stoppage.
End of the day, it's always about fighter safety, especially our amateur fighters. We want to make sure that they live and they're healthy to fight another day. These guys came out. They brought it. It was only a matter of time before one of these guys went down. And speaking of that, I don't think I'm going to pay the judges tonight because they haven't had to do anything all night.
No, they haven't. Wow. I mean, Raheem looks good in this fight, but it just takes one, especially when you're swinging wild. And Khalil caught him right on the chin. And they had their backs to it, so I didn't see exactly what punch caught him. It looked like a knee to the body to me from where I was sitting, but I don't think that's what it was. I need to see the replay again to see exactly what caught him.
Could have been some fatigue factor. Could have been a punch. But all we know is Killer Breeze wins, and let's take it to the cage for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, here in the V3 cage in Minglewood Hall, we present the official time of 42 seconds in a round number two. Referee Clint Kolesinski calls a halt to the bout due to strikes, declaring your winner by TKO victory, Khalil Killer Breeze Boyd.
All right, Killer Breeze, you had an original opponent that got injured. You wanted to fight. Your last opponent pulled out on you. I'm starting to see a reason why they might be. What do you think about your performance tonight?
Hey, man, that first round didn't go the way I wanted it to, but I listened to my coaches, Donovan Castile and Dan Bass over here. I listened to them in the corner, and they led me to victory.
Impressive win. What do you want next?
Before I forget, I gotta thank God for letting me come out and do this. And next fight, doesn't matter, man. All I want is the belt. So Kenan Smallwood, whenever he's ready, let's go.
There we go. Killer Breeze, Khalil Boyd.